Every class member has an accessibility level that determines where the member will be visible. There are 5 of them available in C#, public, protected internal, and private. The default access level for members of a class is private, and so this access modifier can be left out. All members, regardless of access level, are accessible in the class in which they are declared, the defining class. This is the only place where a private member can be accessed. A protected member can also be accessed from within a derived class, but it is inaccessible from other classes. The public access level gives unrestricted access from anywhere that the member can be referenced. This is the least restrictive access level. An internal member can be accessed anywhere within the local assembly, but not from another assembly. In .NET, an assembly is either a runnable program or a DLL library, represented by its own project in Visual Studio. To demonstrate this, let's add a new project through the Solution Explorer. Whereas the main project is set as an executable, this will be a class library project which will compile into a DLL file. A DLL file does not require a main method, whereas an executable assembly needs the main method to compile. To access the MyBase class from the MyLibrary assembly, 2 things are needed. First, MyBase has to be set to public. The second step is to add the first project as a reference to the second project. To do this, right-click on References and select Add Reference. Choose the Projects tab and pick My Project. The MyBase class can now be accessed from MyLibrary. Among its members, only the public member is accessible. Both the internal and protected internal members are inaccessible, because this is outside of the assembly where they are declared. Protected internal means either protected or internal, so in addition to its own assembly, this protected internal member will also be accessible in a class that derives from MyBase. A top-level member is a type declared outside of any other types. In addition to classes, other members that can be declared on the top level include interfaces, structs, enums, and delegates. By default, these uncontained members are given internal access. To be able to use a top-level member from another assembly, as seen earlier, the member has to be marked as public. This is the only other access level allowed for top-level members. A class may contain inner classes, which can be set to either one of the 5 access levels. The access levels have the same effect on inner classes as they do on other members. If the class is inaccessible, it cannot be instantiated or inherited. By default, inner classes are private, which means that they could only be used within the class where they are defined. As a guideline when choosing an access level, it is generally best to use the most restrictive level possible. This is because the more places a member can be accessed, the more places it can be accessed incorrectly, which makes the code harder to debug. Using restrictive access levels will also make it easier to modify the class without breaking the code for any other programmers using that class.